Today, friends, we are going to play with a sweet mechanism created by Xavier and running in SimLab. So let's get cracking. We're going to get there today with a bit.ly. So type bit.ly/, and we're going to put X for Xavier and Marble, and press enter. This takes you to the SimLab marble climbing machine created by Xavier. This fantastic project is set to copy and tinker so we can learn from it. Don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad: give a reaction before you copy and tinker. Before I hit copy and tinker, friends, I just want to note this kind of makes me sad. Users have hit copy and tinker almost 9,000 times, and only 267 of us have given a reaction. Friends, if you've ever used this, go back, give a reaction. It's that easy. Even if you're not going to copy and tinker right now, you can always give a reaction. Now that we're in the project, I'm going to click on home so we can see it from a better angle. What we've got right here is a mechanism where these two parts are connected together, and it's going to scoop to lift it to the next spot. So friends, let me take this to SimLab and show you how it works. When we click on the SimLab button, you need to wait for the geometry to pop. This happened pretty quickly, so now I can move right over here and I can hit play. Notice that scoops the ball. This has a little bit of a slant. It gets caught at the other side and it moves through. All the way up the top, it works without fail. It is pretty darn amazing. As we zoom in, you may wonder, how do these two not collide with each other? The trick is because they are connected to each other, so that cancels out what would be a collision. All the way to the top it goes. Of course, we can always hit pause. We can zoom back and check it out from every angle. I'm going to hit reset real quick, and I'm going to go back to the main page, and I'm going to start by doing this. I want to click on this ball, and I want to put it in another location. I'm going to do Control D to duplicate, C to cruise, and I'm going to grab the dot, and I'm going to just put it one row above. Just for fun, I'm going to make it a different color, and then I'm going to do Control D, and I'm going to do it again. Once again, I'm going to hit the letter C to cruise, and I want to make sure I set it on the center of that rail. Notice as I spin around, I was not quite perfect on that, so I'm going to nudge it into the correct spot. Otherwise, it'll bounce when it goes. Let's pick a different color on this one as well, and I'm going to do Control D to make one more. This one, I'm going to try and just lift it straight up, and I think that's going to be fine. Let's hit play and try it one more time. Now there's a little more action. Check it out, they time up so it's actually all synced. What a fantastic contraption by Xavier. Of course, never ending and so darn fun. All right, so I love watching this. I'm gonna back up to the build mode and let me just show you again quickly how this works. So this is an axle. You can find these axles right down here in the SimLab connectors. When it was brought out, it was aligned. So if we grab these two and choose L for align, you can see it's already in the middle, and the middle right here. Now when we look at its connections, it's got one piece connected to the ramp, and then the other one, I'll have to get it to an angle, you can see is connected to this. That's why these two can go around each other and not have a collision issue. If we look at this part, you can see it's a complex shape. If we double click, it is just a trough made out of a couple boxes squished together. I'm going to click to finish that edit. Same thing over here. If we click on this, it is also a complex shape. I'm going to quickly hit ungroup until it breaks all the way into a single piece. Real quickly, if we ungroup these, we can find out that this is just a tube cut in half. That is a really slick way to make the rails. I'm going to do Control Z to back that up so it regroups. Once again, this all works because these two pieces are connected with these handles. That allows them to interact so that it scoops the ball, dumps it, and moves on. It is an elegant solution, and Xavier, thanks again for sharing. Friends, as I wrap up, let's take a look at the HLMT23 tag. we've got an entry for the Shadow Art Challenge by the Rizla. As you can see, I have given it a reaction. These objects all combine to make an interesting shape. I'm not going to spoil it. You can figure it out by hitting view in 3D. If you want to see the original challenge, you can click right here to find it. We also have the pin Final Boss by EX. That is absolutely fantastic. Don't forget, you can always get here by just typing HLMT23 or the bit.ly/new HLMT23. So many amazing designs. Of course, I will always check them out and give them a reaction. As I look through them, there's so many awesome projects. A cool vent adapter. I'm going to give that a wow. And then also a sweet ninja star. That turned out absolutely awesome. Friends, I do want to highlight, when you click on any user, of course, right here, you can learn all about the project that they're sharing. Note that this one has info inside to see how you could possibly get featured in a video. And then also I want to highlight, if you click on the user's name, you can see all their projects. Currently, they are sorted by last edited, but you can also sort by reactions to see what the most popular projects they ever created are. Of course, with any of my projects, there is likely a tutorial that shows you how to do it. Also, if you check the images, you'll find other amazing projects. And finally, the reactions are always appreciated. Speaking of reactions, let's quickly click on the gallery. And then I'm going to shut off the staff picks. I like to switch to the larger grid mode. And now you can instantly see all the projects that have been recently published. Take a moment to give it a reaction. You just never know whose day you might be making. That's awesome. As I wrap up, friends, I want to say one more time, please take a moment, give reactions, especially when you hit copy and tinker. Friends, as I wrap up, I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that's chosen a YouTube membership. 3 different levels, and of course, with every level, you get early access to videos. I also want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via Patreon. Love how that community is growing. There is a sweet messaging area. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.